Namaste. Welcome to the next video of Machine Learning Techniques course. In this video, we'll discuss multi-output or multi-label regression problems. In case of multi-output regression problems, there are more than one output labels, all of which are real numbers. So this is the main difference between the single label regression problem and multi-output or multi-label regression problem. In case of single label regression problem, we have a single real number as an output, whereas in case of multi-output regression problem, we have more than one output labels. Let's look at the training data for multi-output regression problem. The training data D consists of pairs of a feature matrix and a label matrix. So we have n examples where there is a feature vector associated with each example, and then there is a corresponding label vector. And this label vector is in RK, where K is the number of output labels. In simple term, the label vector has K components that are real numbers. So let us generate synthetic data for demonstrating the training set of multi-output regression problem. We'll be making use of make regression utility from sklearn library for generating this training data. Here we generate 100 samples, each with 10 features and 5 different outputs. So we have a multi-output or multi-label regression problem that has got K, which is number of output labels, equal to 5. We set coefficient equal to true so that we can also retrieve the coefficient or the weight vector that was used to generate this data. We can use this weight vector later to compare it against the estimated weight vector through the regression procedure. And we set the random state to 42 in order to have the repeatability of experiment. In other words, we would like to generate exactly the same data across different experiment runs. Let's check shapes of inputs and outputs. X, which is a feature matrix, has got 100 examples, and each example has got 10 features. And Y, which is a label matrix, has got 100 examples, each example has got 5 different outputs or 5 different components. Let's look at first 5 examples in terms of their features and labels. So you can see that these are first 5 examples, training examples, and these are first 5 labels. Remember, the examples are across rows and labels are also across rows. So for this is the first example, and for this example, this is the corresponding label vector. So we have listed down 5 examples over here and corresponding 5 label vectors. Since we have 5 output labels, for each output label, there is a corresponding feature vector containing number of elements equal to number of features. So in this case, there are 10 features. So we have a feature vector containing 10 entries. We'll reuse the dummy feature addition and training test split function from the linear regression collab. So this particular preprocess function essentially adds a dummy feature corresponding to the bias term, and it also splits the training and test data into it also obtains training and test data from the given input. So now we have training and test feature matrix and training and test label matrix. Let's look at the linear regression model for multi-output regression. Here, the label Y is obtained as a product of feature matrix and a weight matrix. The label matrix Y has shape of n cross k. The feature matrix has shape of n cross m plus 1. This additional one is for the bias unit, the dummy feature that we add. M is the number of features, n is the number of examples, and this is the weight matrix, which has got m plus 1 rows and k columns. In this equation, the output label Y is a matrix. In order to generate multiple outputs, we need one weight vector per output. Hence, here we need total k weight vectors corresponding to k outputs. So we have two options to model this problem. Either we can solve this problem as k independent linear regression problem, one for every output. This gives us some flexibility in using different representations for each problem. Alternatively, we can solve this problem jointly as outlined in this equation, and we would be pursuing this approach in this collab. Now that we have understood the training data and model component of multi-output regression problem, let's look at the remaining three components, namely loss, optimization, and evaluation procedure. We use same loss function as the linear regression, that is sum of squared error, except for the fact that y over here is a matrix as against a vector in case of single label linear regression. But the mathematical form remains the same. We can optimize the loss function through normal equation route or using gradient descent or its variations. And this is part of iterative optimization procedures. And as evaluation, we use root mean squared error or loss as measure, just like single label linear regression problems. We slightly modify the linear regression implementation, and the single modification that we have done is in the weight vector. The weight vector was earlier it was a weight vector for us. Now we have changed that weight vector to weight matrix. We initialize the weight matrix to a matrix of zeros with the shape m plus 1 by k. And that's the only change that we do from our single label linear regression class. We instantiate linear regression object and call the fit method in order to estimate the parameter or the weight matrix for the multi-output regression problem. It takes input, which is a feature matrix, and the label matrix, and we have set regularization rate to zero. Then we make sure that the weight matrix that we obtain here is same as the coefficient matrix that was used for generating the data. And we do that using np.testing.assert almost equal function. And we can see that both this, the estimated feature matrix and the coefficient matrix, they match closely. Let's check out the estimated weight vector. So one more note over here, we check this weight matrix from the first index, and we compare that with the coefficient matrix. And why do we do that? Because we add a dummy variable corresponding to the bias term, and hence our W, which is a weight matrix, has got the bias as the first component. And hence we essentially exclude the first entry while comparing it with the coefficient matrix. So this is our W matrix. The weight vector, so each weight vector is along the columns. So the weight vector corresponding to the first label is 1, 93.62, 89.48, so on up to 16.74. And these are 11 entries. The first one corresponds to the bias unit, and the remaining ones corresponds to the corresponding feature values. And there are 10 features here, so these are 10 different weights corresponding to 10 different features. And this is for the first output. This is the feature vector for the second output, third output, fourth output, and fifth output. So this is the estimated weight matrix. It has got weight vector for individual label. And we also estimate the weight matrix using gradient descent procedure by using number of epochs of 100 and learning rate of 0.01. And we again check the estimated weight matrix with the coefficient matrix that was used for generating the data. And you can see that both of them, they match quite closely. The single output regression problem and multi-output regression problems are similar in most aspects, except for the fact that the output in single label regression problem is a scalar quantity, whereas in multi-output regression problem, the output label is a vector of real numbers. Because of this similarity, we could almost reuse the linear regression implementation that we wrote for single label regression problems. So there are a couple of exercises I would like you to do. One is you should try to solve the multi-label regression problem as k-independent single label regression problem. So write the code for that. And second, you should generate data set with non-linear relationship between input and output and fit a polynomial regression model with appropriate regularization. That concludes our discussion on regression. In the next module, we'll study classification problems. Until then, goodbye and happy machine learning.